Today, you're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. A gaffe happened in Pingdong ahead of the annual Hanguang exercise when a military armored vehicle along with 10 people on board were stranded while crossing the river. The army says all personnel were saved and the incident is under investigation.
The Pingdong County has seen several consecutive days of torrential rains and stronger currents in its rivers. On August 10th, a clouded leopard armored vehicle, which belongs to the 6th Army Corps, was trying to cross the Baoli River before it was completely stranded. The infantry fighting vehicle carried troops in a routine training exercise at the Joint Operation Training Base Command in Hengchun. It stalled as it was crossing the river, trapping the 10 troops aboard inside. The military promptly launched a rescue operation in which the vehicle and all men were saved.
还有装具等等都安全地撤出。
The clouded leopard IFV is an eight-wheel armored vehicle that was designed to conform Taiwan's terrain. It weighs 22 tons and could speed up 105 kilometers per hour. The military said the cause of accident is under investigation. As the unit trains for dangerous situations daily, they were well prepared and for all situations, in this case, thefts were prevented. The vehicle has been towed away and remained undamaged.
The Taidong International Balloon Festival had barely gotten underway in Shishang when one balloon caught on fire. Luckily, it was not carrying any passengers at the time. The organizers said the balloon is repairable and the festival will continue despite the incident.
The first flight of the 11th Taidong International Balloon Festival took off on August 9th due to weather. An event is merely open to Taidong residents in light of the epidemic. At 6 p.m. on August 10th, an unexpected gust of wind knocked over four balloons that were being prepped. One caught fire. Fortunately, there were no passengers at the time. The pilot extinguished the flame and ground crew ran into the forest to retrieve the envelope and burner equipment. The Taidong County government says green lights for flights would only been given should the weather condition have been assessed. The incident was caused by a rare and sudden strange wind and no balloon have caught fire ever before.
在过程里面，突然间发生的，那这种现象基本上，非常非常的少见，那而且是瞬间的强势的逆向的气流。
A county official explained that the incident was reported to the Civil Aeronautics Administration in accordance with due processes. In addition, the balloon is repairable and the incident will not affect the continuation of the festival.
Numerous lawmakers from both parties are still trying to talk the central government into reconsidering its decision of issuing so-called quintuple voucher. They say paying $1,000 for vouchers would create a financial burden on citizens. The Kuomintang, meanwhile, said it's organizing a truck parade around the executive yuan to make sure their messages are heard.
At 10:20 a.m., cars started arriving at the presidential residence. Premier Su Zhenchang arrived at 10:30 a.m. to brief President Tsai Ing-wen on the quintuple voucher plan. According to reports, details on the voucher program could be announced before the end of the month. The central government is facing criticism from even its own lawmakers, who say this has been an extremely tough year, and the central government shouldn't be forcing citizens to pay $1,000 for vouchers.
如果拿够摕1000块，才会使去换钱的话，讲实在，一家人9个人，就要摕9000块去换，这是对人民一种负担。其实这段时间里面都有各方的意见，包含民进党内哦，不管是行政院也好，我们党团内部也好，那或者各方我们都在收集意见，所以这个本来就是一个收集意见。
然后最后再做政策决定的一个过程。The Kuomintang meanwhile is calling for relief in the form of cash and using some trucks to make sure executive yuan officials hear the message.
现在任何一个网络民调你去做，绝对八成以上赞成发现金啦。否则，与我们民进党的立法委员朋友，他们是敏感度最高的，他不会有这么多的立委站出来讲说。
The debate on relief and bailout programs will continue, but one thing all sides can agree on is the economy needs help.
Taiwan's Mainland Affairs Council said ROC citizens should carefully consider any trips to China, Hong Kong, or Macau and do so at their own risks, as new immigration regulations have now allowed the authorities to restrict anyone from entering or leaving Hong Kong.
New entry regulation allowing the director of the Immigration Department to restrict anyone from entering or leaving Hong Kong went into effect on August 1st. The director can also forbid airlines and transportation companies from carrying specific individuals. Canada recently issued a travel warning telling citizens they may not be allowed to leave Hong Kong if they travel there. Taiwan's Mainland Affairs Council, meanwhile, told citizens their personal safety could be at risk if they travel to China, Hong Kong or Macau.
我们希望港府在执行相关法律时要尊重民众的出入境自由，避免损及国际社会与香港间的正常交流。我们会持续关注香港出入境限制相关的发展以及具体实施的情形，尽力维护国人入出香港的自由与权利。
A local human rights group says Hong Kong has turned into a giant prison. Former Mainland Affairs Council Deputy Minister Alistair Huang says this is a power play by China, and ROC citizens that find themselves barred from leaving Hong Kong might not be able to find help as Taiwan no longer has a representative office in Hong Kong.
现在国际社会流行这个相互制裁，借由这个手段呢，啊，留置啊境外人士。那么很可能对香港这个再进一步扼杀了它未来的发展空间。那么我们又没有公权力的代表在香港，它处理问题啊就会复杂的更多。
Huang also said resolution mechanisms should be established before they are needed, and the solutions to other cross-strait issues can only be achieved through bilateral dialogue. However, this will depend on political intelligence from leaders on both sides of the strait.
China has recalled its ambassador to Lithuania over Taiwan's plans to set up a representative office in Lithuania.In response, Lithuania's Ministry of Foreign Affairs reaffirms its intention to establish relations with Taiwan. The U.S. meanwhile said it welcomes countries to create constructive ties with Taiwan.
针对立陶宛政府宣布允许台湾当局以台湾名义设立所谓代表处，严重损害中国主权和领土完整，中方坚决反对，决定召回中国驻立陶宛大使。
On August 10th, China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs announced that it's recalling the ambassador to Lithuania over Taiwan's plan to set up a Taiwan representative office in Lithuania. It also requested that Lithuania recalls its ambassador to China. In response, Lithuania's Ministry of Foreign Affairs said it regrets this statement and reiterates its determination to jointly develop a mutually beneficial relationship with Taiwan. Member of the Lithuanian parliament tweeted hearts to show that they don't feel sorry whatsoever for the decision. Lithuanian Foreign Affairs Minister Gabrielis Landsbergis said they will stand firmly against pressure from China.
Well, we do stand in solidarity with our NATO ally Lithuania, and we condemn the PRC's recent retaliatory actions. We support our European partners and our allies as they develop mutually beneficial relations with Taiwan and resist the PRC's coercive behavior.
The U.S. Department of State denounced China's coercive behavior and said it encouraged other countries to allow Taiwan to set up representative offices. Meanwhile, the European Union said it does not believe Lithuania's behavior has breached the One China policy, and the EU will closely monitor the development.
外交部已经注意到有关于中国外交部宣布召回他们立陶宛的驻使，并且要求立陶宛政府要召回其驻中国的大使。未来我方会密切注意后续相关的发展。
Taiwan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs said Lithuania's determination to defend the concepts of national dignity and freedom is admirable. It added that the two sides have shared principles and will continue to strengthen the relationship in all areas. Lithuania recently donated vaccines to Taiwan and has plans to set up an office in Taiwan this fall.
Now I'll bring you some top stories from around Taiwan.The Ministry of Labor has expanded the eligibility of its subsidies to include people aged over 65, those receiving labor pensions but still working, and full-time employees whose July salaries were affected. A man surnamed Kwan was sentenced to 10 years in prison after his daughter was killed by an airspray gun at a gas station while he was washing his car. The case can still be appealed. One positive case has been found in the massive testing that's currently underway in the borough of Yonghe District. New Taipei City Mayor Hou Youyi encouraged more local residents to get tested to cut off the transmission chain. Firefighters called to the scene of a fire in Taichung on August 10th and found a 2-year-old boy alone in an apartment. Luckily, he sustained no injuries.
An unattended stove burned the pan black and almost caused an apartment fire on Taichung's Fulong Street. Luckily, firefighters arrived in time and found a 2-year-old boy trapped inside.
一个人在那边，那看到我们这个消抢救人员的时候愣了一下，哦，那后来就嚎啕大哭。
The boy was alone in the department, but fortunately sustained no injuries. His father, a man surnamed Yan, told the police that the boy was given birth by a Vietnamese migrant worker years ago. Yan said she completely disappeared so that he has to raise the boy alone. He never registered his son, making him undocumented.
那只是孩子可能在语言表达上面比较限制，或许是刺激不够，所以他的语言表达能力比较差。
The Taichung City Social Affairs Bureau says the boy's father is willing to continue taking care of him and it will help him register his son so that he can go to school. Under the Protection of Children and Youth Welfare and Rights Act, children aged below 6 or children and youth that need special care should not be left alone. Anyone against the law will be required to attend a maximum of 50 hours of parenting classes. According to the Child Welfare League Foundation, 43 cases of undocumented children were reported last year, along with 38 cases of parent not registering a child's birth within 60 days. The majority of these cases involve migrant worker parents.
害怕雇主知道，所以可能就偷偷把他生下来，甚至可能想办法藏，或者是会有这样的一个弃养，或是请同样是移工的朋友代为照顾的情况。
The foundation says hospitals should proactively file reports about potential situations, and health bureaus should also stay vigilant for similar cases when administering vaccines.
Thank you for watching. I'm Ethan Liu, and see you next time.